What's going on, everybody? It's Joel here, and today we're doing the review of the New Balance Minimus Prevail. The Prevails are New Balance's brand new training shoe, and I believe they're replacing the Minimus 40, which was, I want to say, New Balance's last flagship training shoe. I reviewed this shoe in early 2017, and I actually really liked it. There were some things that I didn't care too much for, but for the most part, I thought the Minimus 40 was one of the best training shoes at the time. I still think it's a really good training shoe. So if you can pick the Minimus 40 up, I highly recommend that you do. But right now there's some pretty limited sizing on these models. But the Minimus Prevails are a very good shoe in their own right, but they're a very different shoe than the Minimus 40s. So the Minimus 40s were very flexible. They were comfortable. The underfoot feeling was pretty plush. There wasn't a ton of stability. I wouldn't say that they were the most stable shoes out of what was available at the time, like the Metcon 3 or the Nano 7, but they were pretty stable in their own right. I actually snatched 225 for the first time in my Minimus 40. So that, I think, speaks volumes for the actual stability of that shoe. The Prevails are kind of like classic New Balance Minimus style shoes. So if you think about like their MT10s, the trail Minimus shoe that everybody used to wear for CrossFit, and the, I want to say, MX20, that was another New Balance Minimus shoe that a lot of people wore when I first started CrossFit in 2012. This shoe reminds me a lot of those shoes in the past. And I'll get to explaining why I think that, but let's talk about the construction and the build quality of the shoe. And typical New Balance, it's built really, really well. The bulk of the upper is a knit type material. It's supposed to be engineered, but there's not a ton of stretch to it. There are TPU fibers woven into the upper and pretty much extends all the way throughout the vamp of the shoe and stops pretty much right about where the ankle collar is. Then you have a more normal feeling back part of the shoe. There's an asymmetrical heel counter that extends through the lateral and medial sides of the shoe. And then that also extends down to cover the midsole and give you a little bit of a TPU heel clip, so you have a little bit more slide up the wall when you do handstand pushups. The midsole that they're using in the Minimus Prevails is the Rev Light midsole. On this model of shoe, it's stiff. It's not soft like it was on the Minimus 40s or on some of New Balance's running shoes. But I actually really like the implementation that they used in the Minimus Prevails. There is a little bit of a toe guard, toe bumper. It's mainly just an overlay. It's not really going to protect you from too much, but should give you a little bit more protection for when you're popping up onto your feet doing burpees in this shoe. The lacing system is nothing special. It basically just goes through an overlay in the top of the shoe, but it does a pretty good job of securing your foot into place. And then you do have an extra hole at the top for lace lock if you wanted to, if you got any heel slip. I have not had any kind of heel slip issues with this shoe, so I really wouldn't worry about that. Otherwise, I feel like the shoe fits very, very well around your heel. One thing that I think they really, really need to make a hot fix for on the Minimus Prevails is the tongue. It is awful. If you lace your shoes up tightly, the tongue will basically start to dig into the base of your shin or the top of your ankles, and there's really no getting around it. I noticed it with and without lace lock. There's really nothing you can do about it if you are lacing up your shoes tightly. If I kind of wear them a little bit looser, then the problem goes away. But for certain movements like rope climbs, you're gonna want your shoes on a little bit more tight. The outsole of the Minimus Prevails is a full length rubber Vibram outsole. It's kind of in one direction, which I find odd compared to most training shoes, but I have no issues with the grip of this shoe. I actually think this outsole does a really, really good job on pretty much any surface. It does an amazing job holding the rope. The sidewalls are raised a little bit in the lateral and medial sides of the shoe to give you more protection against rope burn. And I think they raise them up just enough so that they don't look silly and they kind of just blend into the shoe, which I really like about the Minimus Prevails. The drop of the shoe is 4 millimeters and the weight is 10 ounces. So they're very, very light shoes. From a look standpoint, I think these are a pretty good looking pair of shoes. They're pretty simple, minimalist. There's not a whole lot going on. There's really nothing flashy about the shoe. The two colorways are this black and silver colorway, and then there is a white and black and red colorway, which I think is a little bit better, but I bought this one because I knew I was gonna do rope climbs and kind of trash the shoe, but I think the other colorway looks better. There's nothing particularly standout-ish about the design of the shoe, but there's also nothing offensive. So I think a lot of people are gonna really like the look of the Minimus Prevails. When sizing these shoes, I'm gonna say go with your normal training shoe size. I find that they fit extremely true to size. I do not have a very wide foot, but I don't wanna say I have a narrow foot either. I'm somewhere in between. I do have Morton's toe, and I do have a slight bunion and a collapsed arch on my right foot. And I have no issues with the way that the Minimus Prevails fit. If you had a really, really wide foot, you can actually get these in a 2E as well. So New Balance does offer wide sizes. There's really no arch in the shoe of which to speak. It's a very flat and plain feeling shoe inside. So I think a lot of wide footers are gonna really like the fit of the Minimus Prevails. New Balance always does a really good job with maintaining flexibility in their training shoes, and the Prevails are no exception. These are extremely flexible training shoes, and I think they are even more so than the outgoing Minimus 40s. To me, they feel very similar to the old MX20s and the MT10s. They're basically like a combination of those two shoes. If you never used either of those shoes, the MX20 had a very flat feeling profile, and then the MT10s had a ton of ground feel. And the Prevails are kind of like a mix of both of them. They feel very flat, but you do get a ton of feedback from the ground, especially in comparison to even the Minimus 40s. The trade-off though is you don't get as much underfoot cushioning as the outgoing shoe. So while running in these shoes is okay because they're light and flexible, they do feel a little bit clacky when you make contact with the ground, but that's to be expected from a minimalist shoe. On the flip side, they are very responsive training shoes. Double unders are easy to track. Box jump rebounding is easy to do. It's comfortable to get up from doing burpees. They don't really burn your feet out too much. And overall, I think they're fairly comfortable shoes to train in. Because these shoes are extremely responsive, lifting in them is excellent. One thing that I did not really care too much for with the Minimus 40s was lifting in them. I guess I hit that snatch PR, so I can't really complain too much, but I did think that they were a little bit on the soft side, plus they didn't hold your foot in place all that great. The Prevails do a much better job on both of those fronts. The profile of this shoe, like I said before, is very, very flat and neutral. The outsole is also very flat, has very well-defined edges. Power delivery in this shoe is excellent. There's really nothing to get in the way between your foot and the ground. The midsole is very thin, so the stack height is very low to the ground. So you get a lot of feedback from the ground when you're doing your lifts. The asymmetrical heel counter does a great job in cupping your heel into place. And then you get a little bit more contact area with the ground because of the way that the heel extends out at the back of the shoe. The Prevails are a very neutral feeling lifting shoe, so things like deadlifts and squats are gonna feel really good to do in this shoe. I took it up to a 395 back squat, which is 30 pounds under my one rep max. I did some sumo deadlifts in this shoe and they held my foot in place very good. The traction is also very good on these shoes. The toe spring angle is pretty non-existent, so you do get a very grounded feeling when you wear the Minimus Prevails. For Olympic weightlifting, I thought these shoes were pretty good. They're not amazing. I don't think they're as good as either the Nano 9s or the Metcon 5s. They don't feel as dynamic off the ground, and they're also not as stable laterally as either of those shoes. foot containment is okay in this shoe. I did notice a little bit of instability whenever I had any kind of weight overhead, so I wouldn't be going for any kind of one rep max jerks or snatches. But for the majority of the weights that you're gonna find in a typical workout, I don't think you're gonna have any issues putting them up in the Minimus Prevails. The Minimus Prevails retail for $120, which is $10 less than your flagship training shoes, the Metcon 5s and the Nano 9s. I think these are an excellent pair of training shoes in their own right, but I don't think that they are better than either of those flagships or the Innovate 235 V3s. Who I'd recommend these shoes to are someone that's looking for a more basic feeling shoe, something that's more neutral inside, something that's a little bit more flat, close to the ground, something flexible, doesn't have a lot of cushioning, more of your traditional minimalist trainer, which the Minimus line is kind of built on. The first thing that I thought of when I put these shoes on was that they reminded me a lot of the original Minimus shoes, and I'm gonna stick with that. The Prevails are an ode to the Minimus shoes of old. They stray away from the Minimus 40 formula because they don't have as much cushioning, they're not as plush underfoot, but they do have a lot more ground feel. They feel closer to the ground, and I think a lot of people are really gonna like that, especially old school Minimus fans. If you guys have any questions about the Minimus Prevails, feel free to leave them in the comment section. And as always, guys, please hit that like button, subscribe, and thanks for watching.